Okay. So in this talk, I'm going to quickly define abelian group and introduce some notation associated with abelian groups. So a group is termed abelian if any two elements of the group commute. Okay, which means xy is yx or all xy in the group. Now remember that for groups, we generally don't put a symbol for the binary operation. So xy actually just means x star y, where star is the binary operation of the group. But I'm not writing that. Okay? So this just means x star y is y star x, but I just write it in short as xy equals yx. Now, do I allow x and y to be equal?
Yeah.
Yes. But actually, it doesn't make any difference, right? Because when x and y are equal, they'll commute anyway. Right?
Right.
So it doesn't really matter whether I insist x and y are equal or whether I allow x and y to be equal or whether I don't allow it, because when they're equal, it's anyway true. Okay. But the point is any two elements commute. Now, if you are working in an abelian group, then there are some slightly different notations that are more convenient. So I'm going to talk about that, but you should remember that this notation is not always used for an abelian group. If you are working with an abelian group which is living inside some bigger group which is not abelian, you typically use the standard notation, the multiplicative notation. Okay? But if you are working with abelian groups in isolation, then we typically use this slightly different notation, which is additive notation. This blue thing here is additive notation. So how does that go? Well, the group operation, the group multiplication now is denoted by addition symbol, by plus. And what do we mean when I say infix operator plus? What I mean is that when I have x and y, how do I denote their group operation on them? I denote it as x plus y. Okay? Instead of what? If I were using multiplicative notation, what would I have said?
X star y.
X, or if I were doing this short multiplicative notation, I would have written xy, but now I write x plus y. The identity element is denoted 0. Okay? Because if you think of addition, the usual addition of integers or real numbers, then the identity element for addition is in fact 0. Right? So in keeping with that, we denote the identity element for abelian groups as 0. Instead of what? What's the symbol for identity element when we're dealing with groups in general?
1.
Yeah. It's 1. Sometimes you use E for if you want to keep it abstract. But we don't use 0 generally. But for abelian groups, we use 0 when we're using the additive notation. The inverse element is denoted with a prefix operator minus. What that means is that the inverse of A, is this here?
Mm-hmm.
The inverse of A is denoted minus A instead of A inverse. Okay? The minus is put as a prefix on the left. Okay? And finally, powers, x to the n, are denoted as multiples. So what this means is that, let's say I have x plus x plus x plus x. Let's say this. How would I write that in short?
A 4.
4x. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I put the multiple, the number of times it occurred on the image left. Suppose I have minus x plus minus x plus minus x. What does that become?
Minus 3x.
Minus 3. Is this here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now there's also another shorthand, which is, a slight variant of the shorthand, which is, if I want to write x plus minus y, I can sometimes write it as x minus y, if I want. Okay, so when I write x minus y, what it really means is x plus minus y. Okay, so I can use this notation for subtraction. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So it's just like you deal with addition of real numbers, addition subtraction of real numbers, integers, etc. So even if I didn't tell you this notation, you would probably guess it, but just for completeness, I'm telling you. Okay. Now, what are some examples of abelian groups? Well, let's think of abelian groups where the group operation is actually what you usually think of as addition. What are some examples?
Abelian groups?
Hmm?
Real numbers.
Real numbers. What else? Can you think of some subgroups of this, which are things inside the real, which are still abelian groups?
Integers.
Anything in between these?
Rationals.
Rationals. Right. For all of these, they are closed under addition. There's a, the zero, they have a zero, which is just the usual zero, and they are closed under subtraction, which is just the usual. So, I mean, they're closed under the negation operation. It's just the usual, taking the minus or something. What about the natural numbers? Do they form a group under ordinary addition? Is it positive integers?
No.
No? Why?
Or have a zero element.
And they don't have inverses, right? They're got it. Not the natural numbers. Okay. Now, what about groups under ordinary multiplication, where the group operation is what you usually think of as multiplication?
Mm-hmm.
Can you think of some groups like that?
The reals.
Well, not all the reals. There's something in the reals which doesn't have an inverse, right?
Zero.
So what can you do?
A score zero.
Yeah, so that's denoted R star. That's just R minus zero. That's a group under multiplication. And if you're getting it as a group under multiplication, we could just stick to the multiplicative notation. So for abelian groups, you can choose whether to use the multiplicative or additive notation, right? The usual multiplicative or the blue additive notation. So this we would, maybe we just stick with the multiplicative notation, because that's the one we seem to be coming up with. Anything else?
Rationals.
Not all the rationals.
Excluding
zero. Q star. Can you do the integers excluding zero?
No.
Why not?
I have the inverse.
Don't have inverses. Okay. Good. Great.